Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. This is website studysalesforce.com. So here you can find all the videos on Salesforce. Those are created by me. In this video, we are going to discuss about after undelete operation in Apex Trigger. And this is the scenario. So in my previous video, I demonstrated you before delete and after delete operation. So in continuation with that, so we are going to understand after undelete operation. So if you have not watched that video, so I will prefer first you go through with before delete and after delete, then you can easily understand after undelete operation. So scenario is we need to undelete employee record that we were trying to delete and performing before delete and after delete operations. So if that record is deleted and then we undelete that employee record, so we need to set the active field as true. So a requirement was when we were trying to delete the employee record, so first we need to uncheck or make active field as false, then we were able to delete that. But when we are undeleting that record, so we need to set that as true. And later on, I will also tell you how we can maintain that left employee count field as decremented. So in previous video I showed you that if we open any account record and if we go to the details, so we have this field left employee count. So if we delete the record, employee record, so this count is incremented. Now if we are trying to undelete the employee record, so this should be decreased, right? So now moving to employee trigger. So here I use this after undelete event. Then this if condition is checking is after and is undelete, and this method will be executed, undelete employees. In case of undelete, we have trigger.new, right? So this you need to remember. And here I have implemented a simple method. So first I'm going to show you whenever you delete any employee record, so we mark that active checkbox as false. But if we are undeleting that employee record, so we need to mark that checkbox as true again. So as this undelete performs in after, so we need to perform DML operation so that we can update the records. So new list is available here. I'm iterating that list, storing the EMP ID into this E variable and marking active as true. Then storing this E into this list, and after completion of iteration, I'm checking this list. If it is not empty, then I'm updating the employee records, right? So this is the simple logic. Now moving to account. So here you can see I'm opening this test record, right? So here, if we move to the details, so here you can see left employee count is 1. So I already deleted one employee record, so that's why it is 1. Now here you can see this employee record is available. I am opening it, so it is active, so I am marking it as inactive, clicking on save, deleting this. So as after delete trigger works, so on details, if I refresh this, you can see left employee count is now 2. And if I see the related, so you can see deleted employee record is not available. Now you have two options. Either you can go to recycle bin and you can undelete the record. Otherwise you can use the developer console anonymous window, right? So if we try to go to recycle bin, so here you can search for recycle bin and you can open it. So here all the deleted records will be available. So right now we deleted this E36, right? So what we need to do, we need to select this record and we need to click on restore. So this record will be undeleted, right? So okay. So if I click on this restore, okay, before restoring this, let me show you how you can undelete from the anonymous window. So from here, you can query the employee record where account ID is this. So this I am hard coding because we need specific employee record should be undeleted. And here you need to pass all rows, right? And then you can run undelete EMP list. So let's try from here. I'm clicking on restore. So here you can see E0036 not available. Now moving to accounts. So we deleted it from test. So on related list, you can see E0036 is available. So while deleted, we marked it as active as false. Now you can see it is automatically true. So this way, this trigger is working fine and this method is working properly. Now, if I go to the details of this account, sorry, I need to go to account. And if I move to the details, so still you will see left employee count is 2. So now my requirement is I need to make it 1 because I undeleted one record. So whenever an employee record is deleted, so it will be incremented by 1. Otherwise, it will, in case of undelete, it should be decremented by 1. So now what you can do, you can copy the code that is available here. So this is the code which is related to after delete. We can use this code as it is. So let me use this code. So I'm putting it here and EMP. So we need to update employee as well and account as well because accounts are related to that. And here we need to apply the condition. So we need to update each and every employee because whenever employee is undeleted, so we need to mark the record as true. Now here I'm going to apply one if condition. If emp.account is not equals to null, right? It means the undeleted employee is related to any account so that we can decrease that left count by 1. So for that, I'm copying this. And I'm pasting it here. So we need to update employee as well as we need to update account. So now I can use this here dot add emp dot account IDs, right? And whatever IDs will be available here, accordingly we will be querying accounts. Now for selected employees, we need to iterate this. So I'm copying this as well, EMP list. So pasting it here, then using it here, EMP list dot add EMP. So account records will be queried from here. We are going to use this map. So I think I'm not copied that. So I need to copy that map as well. Okay, so I'm copying this whole because this count map will also be required. So pasting it here. So this is the account ID, account map, and this is employee list, and this is the account map. Now everything is available here. Logic will be same. Here you need to use -1 in place of +1, right? And rest of the things will be same. So here you can see this will be updating the account and this will be updating the employee records. So now I am saving this. So let me try this thing so that we can understand it. So I am opening one account. ACC EMP1. And if we go to details, so in my previous video, I created 2 employee record and I deleted. So that's why This delete count is 2, and in the related list you can see employees are 0, right? So now I'm going to use this account ID and I'm going to use this, right? So I'm just querying from all rows the employees which are related to this account, and then I will be undeleting them. So when I will be undeleting them, so each employee record will be having active checkbox as true, and the related account will be decremented by the undeleted count of employee records. So yeah, it is saved. It is also saved. Now I'm going to execute this. So let me check this again. So now I'm going to execute this. So it is executed, debug log is open. So I'm just closing this because it is not required now. So I am refreshing this account. So you will see in the related list, two employees will be available, employee records will be available, because we deleted two employee records from this account. So here you can see 34 and 35 are available. So I'm opening them. Meanwhile, I am opening this detail section and refreshing the account so that we can check the left employee count value as well. So in the details, you can see this employee record is active, marked as active. This is also active, 35 and 34, both are active, right? This is because in our trigger, we implemented this thing. On each employee, we are assigning active as true. And for updating the account, left count, we are using the rest of the code that I copied from the above after delete, right? So it is being refreshed. So here you can see left employee count is now 0 because two records are undeleted. So it is now moving back to 0. Now, if I again delete those two, so it will be 2 again, and accordingly it will work, right? So again, you can see here. So all three scenarios are now covered. Before delete, after delete, and after undelete. And this is the before delete code. Then we have after delete code. So where we are filtering, and then this code is implemented. And this is the undelete one. So in undelete, first we are checking, first we are assigning true in active of employee. Then we are checking whether they are related to account or not. If they are related, then we are creating set and employee list. Accordingly, we are querying accounts. Then through employee list, we are decrementing the count by 1, then updating accounts and employee list. So this is the complete code that you can implement, right? And if you want these codes, so you can email me. So my email ID is available on my YouTube channel, as well as on the website link that I mentioned you on the homepage, you can find the email ID. So if you need this code, so email me so that I can send the code to you. Okay, so I hope you understood how undelete is working. If you want to watch more videos, so on this website, you can find the links of those videos related to Salesforce created by me. Thank you for watching this video.